Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison, Senior Program Manager at Microsoft inside of Cloud and AI, and let's take a look at how we can code with different types of loops inside of JavaScript. So I've got my code editor up here. I'm going to take a look at those same three loops that we've seen, which is our while loop, our for loop, and our for of. And just like before, I'm going to do the same demo three times. Now, I am going to use some slightly different variable names as we go through this, just because I'm going to wind up running into a couple of little scoping issues. So I'm just going to use different variable names to avoid that. So let's go ahead and start with our while loop. So let's say console log and our while loop. There we go. And let's also make sure we set up our array, const names equals. And let's go ahead and say Justin and Burke and Sarah. Beautiful. OK, so now I've got my my console log. And let's go ahead and start to write our code. So I'm going to say while index equal to 0. And again, keep in mind that the reason that I'm doing this, that while index, is just to make sure that this is different from the other indexes that I'm going to be declaring here. So I'm just avoiding some scoping issues. OK, so I'm going to say while, and then our while index is less than names.length. And one big thing that I always like to do if I'm going to be the one responsible for changing the expression on a while loop is write that code first. Because if I don't, I'm just going to forget it. So just start there. And now I'll sneak back up to the top here and I'll say const name equals, and we'll say names, and we'll go ahead and grab based on the while index. And then console.log, and then the name. Cool. And so now, if I run this app.js, what you're going to notice is I'm going to get Justin, Burke, and Sarah. So it's going through all the different items. The next one that I've got, so let's go ahead and say console log is our for loop. Boom, boom. And now I'm going to say for, and then I don't have to declare the index outside. It's actually going to give me the syntax to do it right here. So I'm going to say let for index equal 0 as long as my for index is less than, in my case, my names.length. And then finally, for index, and then make sure we increment that with our plus plus. Okay, cool. So now I'm going to go ahead and say one more time, const name equals names. And then in my case, this is going to be the for index. And we'll go ahead and say console log, and then the name. So it's going to give us the exact same results. The big thing that I want to highlight, just like before, just like I mentioned in the prior section, is the fact that I don't need to declare the index separately, that I can do that all in one shot right here. So kind of convenient, kind of nice for that. Now, admittedly, if this is what I'm trying to do, which is to iterate through an array, the one that I'm going to use most frequently is going to be a for of loop. Now, I'm actually going to take a little bit of advantage of Visual Studio Code here, because you'll notice that we've got these little built-in snippets here. And so I can actually just, once I select this, hit Tab, and then it will automatically give me the appropriate code that, that I want here. So I'm actually going to say const name of my object, which is going to be my names. and then one more tab, and then now I can go ahead and say console.log and then print out the name and hit save. And voila, I've let Visual Studio Code go ahead and write some of that code for me, which is pretty cool. So you'll notice that I've got all of that done. Let me go ahead and hit save, and then go ahead and execute that. And then you'll notice down here at the bottom is that for of. Now, one thing that you may have picked up on here, and I just want to call this syntax out, is you may notice right here that it said const name, and you might be thinking to yourself, wait a minute, it's a constant. I'm not able to change that. One really cool thing here is it's going to be constant for just this scope. So it's going to change each time I go through here, but if I tried to say name equals some value, this is going to wind up giving me an error when I run this because it's declared as a constant. So I know that it looks a little bit funny with it sitting there, but believe it or not, it is actually going to still work. And it's actually the preferred mechanism for doing this because it's going to keep you from making a mistake and accidentally changing that by yourself inside of a for loop, which is typically not what you're going to want to do. You're not going to want to reassign the value. You might want to change something on it, change a property on it, but as far as reassigning it, that's typically not something that that you're going to want to do. And again, same results as before. And so that is the three most common loops inside of JavaScript. That's our while loop, our for loop, and our for of.